Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, dead pixels sound really scary, right? When something is dead, there's no coming back to life. So what is the state of your camera's sensor? Or how good is the sensor of the camera you're about to buy? I'd like to show you how to quickly find out if you have dead pixels and where exactly they are located on the sensor. All you need are some sample photos taken with your camera and the tool that I've provided for you in the links below. I'll tell you how to use the tool and how to prepare the photos for it. But first, what do I call dead pixels? These are pixels that are either consistently dark or light or have the same intensity or color in every one of your photos. The always bright pixels are technically hot pixels or stuck pixels, but today I call all problematic pixels dead. So dead pixels do not respond adequately to light. Instead, they are stuck in some state. I have created a tool that gives you the coordinates of faulty pixels. You need to take some sample photos with your camera for this. More photos is better because then the algorithm is more accurate. You see, a problematic pixel should be problematic in every photo. The optimal number of photos to take is 5 to 7. The photos should be of a flat, uniform surface with consistent lighting. One such example might be a wall or ceiling in your home. Avoid natural variations that could mimic dead pixels. If you use a tripod, move the camera a bit between different shots. Ideally, the different photos should have different settings. Vary shutter speed, ISO, and lighting. For hot pixel detection, those that are constantly white, take darker frames. For cold pixel detection, those that are constantly dark, take lighter frames. Or just use an intermediate brightness for all. My dead pixel tool can handle JPEG, PNG, and TIFF. But if you're using JPEG, make sure to turn off noise reduction and corrections. Use the highest quality JPEG setting available to minimize compression artifacts. However, even then, the JPEG engine may obscure the identities of dead pixels. So if possible, do not use JPEG. It's better to record a RAW file instead, and then convert the RAW file, without applying any modifications, into PNG or TIFF for analysis. I use RAW Therapy for that. My RAW Therapy tutorial is linked below. Note that the photo doesn't need to be super sharp. The problematic pixels will still be in the same place. However, sharpness ensures the adjacent pixels are not affected by focus blur, which might slightly smooth pixel values and reduce the contrast between dead pixels and their neighbors. I always use a tripod, but you really don't have to. Note that you must not crop your images. It is important that the photos are all exactly the same size. So you should take about 3 to 7 photos. 3 is the recommended lower limit and 5 is already quite good. After taking the photos, you are ready to run the script. Next, download the script deadpixels.py via the link in the text box. Put the script in the same folder as your images. Then use the terminal to navigate into that folder and run the script as a Python script. These are the examples for Linux, Mac, and Windows. This is the default command line, Python 3, deadpixels.py, and the names of the photos. This is the same as writing Python 3, deadpixels.py, names of the files, and threshold 15. If you do not have Python installed, or the script is giving you errors, please check the relevant links in the text box below. I have talked about these topics in my other software videos, so there's no reason to repeat them here. The links take you to the correct place in the other videos where I discuss exactly these topics, so you don't have to watch the entire videos. I'm trying to save you some time. You will notice that the script is slow. This is because it has a lot of computation to perform. When it's done, you will see the coordinates of the problematic pixels. Don't freak out if the list looks long. It is possible that the photos were not suitable. Maybe try again with different or more photos, or change the sensitivity of the method. Here's how. So if this is the command line, it would be exactly the same as writing this line. To increase sensitivity, change the value behind threshold. To be more certain of the pixel detection, try higher values. A good range is typically between 10 and 20. My recommended value is the default value of 15. If you use 10, then the method is more sensitive, but you might also get more false positives. Maybe start with 15. If the tool detects dead pixels, it's a good idea to repeat the experiment with some modifications to ensure the results are trustworthy. If you have a DSLR or a hybrid camera that allows the lens to be removed, take off the lens and blow some air on the sensor using a rubber bulb air blower. If no dead pixels are detected after this treatment, it proves that the problem was caused by dust on the sensor, not dead pixels. If the location of dead pixels has changed, then that also indicates dust because true dead pixels should always be in the same place, no matter the treatment. If you cannot remove the lens, for example, because you have a compact camera, try using different f-stop values and ISO settings. If changing these parameters makes the dead pixels disappear, you most likely did not have dead pixels to begin with. Whatever you're seeing, I'm here to answer your questions. All you need to do is drop me a line in the comments and I will help you. But are dead pixels a problem and how common are they, you might ask? Even new cameras can have faulty sensors that are not eliminated in quality control. But as the camera ages and the shutter count increases, the sensor can also start deteriorating. It is quite common for a camera to have some dead pixels. If it's a very small number and the pixels are not next to each other, then this is not a big problem. So before you buy a used camera, you may want to ask the seller for 3 to 5 randomly taken photos with the camera, preferably RAW files. Then run them through my script and then decide if you still want to buy that camera. Lastly, let me test my Fuji XE2 with this script. I've used 5 photos I took of a wall. The script found 2 dead pixels. The good news is that they are far from each other. I wrote another script that allows you to look at the dead pixels. I call it cutpiece.py because it cuts out the problematic pixel with a bit of surrounding photo so that you can take a closer look. You can download this script in the text box as well. And you run it like this: Python, cutpiece, a number, infile, outfile, and 2 numbers. The script takes infile PNG and cuts out an 11 by 11 rectangle from this photo so that the center coordinates are x equals 1000 and y equals 2000. The numbering for both of my scripts starts from the upper left. So if 1000 and 2000 are the coordinates of your dead pixel, you can now see what it looks like compared to its immediate neighbors. Here are different images of one of my dead pixels. It sits right in the middle of 5 layers of pixels around it. You can see that my dead pixels is really a stuck pixel, and it has an intermediate brightness value. This is good news. At least it is not always bright white or pitch black. So my camera sensor is actually in pretty good condition. I can live with a couple of intermediate gray pixels. But again, when you see dead pixels, clean the sensor with an air blower and repeat the experiments one more time. Also, test several threshold values, but threshold 15 is a good middle ground that I trust. Also, take a look at your pixel with my cutpiece.py script, as I explained earlier. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know how many dead pixels you detected. If you found my today's video useful and would like to see more similar content, please consider subscribing to my channel and leaving a like. This helps me continue my channel work. See you again soon. Goodbye.